Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Myself Vikas Nitsa. In this video we are going to see how to find out DFT in MATLAB without using FFT command. So here, this is a MATLAB software, so just we have to start with the first programming. This is the editor window. So basically when we develop a program to find out a DFT without using a inbuilt command, we have to use a two editor window. One is a .m file and obviously another one is a function file. Okay, we have to call a function, then only the we can build a program. Okay, so for that, so let's start the program. So percentage find DFT using and DFT without using FFT command. So let's start. So first here I have taken a CLC command to clear the command window. Then here I have taken a input of 4 samples, 1 1 0 0. Then I can write the functions, that is out is the output argument equal to DFT is a function name, in bracket I can take input argument, that is RN comma length number of, for how many points we are finding the DFT, that's 8. Okay, now I can write a function file for that. So this is the function, so I have to write a program for this function. So just go to the new, here have a function, just click on the function file, you will get a this new window. So function, so in that you have to write output argument, that is out. Here you have to write function name, that is a DFT, input argument that we have taken, that is in, comma number of length, that is a. So for that 8 I am going to take capital L. Then find out the length of that samples, L minus length of input, so it will subtract 8 minus total number of sample, that is a 4. So you will get a 4. Length is equal to len is equal to 4. So now I can make addition of 0, that is in how many 0, again you have to add 4 zeros because it's a 8 minus 4, again you are getting a 4, so 4 zeros will be add, so you will get a result 1100 and again 0000. So you have to write 1 comma ln, sorry len bracket complete, square bracket complete. Next, now I can find out the length, actual length after adding the zeros. So now again I can write n length of in. Next I can find out, that is n1 is equal to n minus 1. Then next, first I will take the value become 0, then I will make increment in that. So then I will take empty matrix, then I will write for loop for k is equal to, it will start from 0 as 2 and 1, because already we have done n minus 1, so there is no need to take n minus 1, we have taken that value into n1. So basically I am using the logic by using a total factor. So again for I is equal to, in place of small n I am using I, that is I is equal to 0 0 as 2 again n1. Now here I can write a total factor formula, that is n in bracket, first basically we write input, So it will take a first input I plus 1. So initially the value of I becomes 0, so it will take a first sample. So exponential, that is e raised to minus j 2 pi k a n divided by capital N. So I will write e exponential bracket minus j into 2 into pi into I into k bracket complete divided by n. So this is nothing but total factor formula. Then I have to add whatever result I got, I have to write it, I have to take into the d. So here I have taken d plus g, then I will take that result into the sum, then I will make end of the first for loop, then again I will make 0 in that, again I will put that value into the final matrix. So I will round that value, I will make the summation of that, so you will get a proper final result sum n square bracket complete. Again I will make second for loop, then out is equal to, now finally I will take whatever the result into the out, then I have to complete this function. So once again I have to come into the first program, so in that I have to write k is equal to 0 as to 1 as to 7. So first I will write subplot in bracket 2, 2, 1. I will take stem k comma absolute of out, then next again I will make grid on, so it will make a horizontal and vertical lines, then title, that is a DFT, simply I will make this is a DFT. Now I will find out the phase, so just I have to change the subplot. Here I will make angle, so again you can change the phase of DFT. So now you can save this file in any location. I keep as it is name. Again I have to say, whenever you save the function file, so give the same name that what you have given for that program. Okay, for example dft.m, because our function name is dft, that file should be saved in the form of dft. Okay, so just now this is all about the program. Now just go to the run option, just click. Now you can check, this is the result, this is the DFT samples and the phase of that DFT. There are total 8 samples because we have taken a basically first we have taken a 4 sample and then we make the addition of that, means we are adding the zeros, so there are total zeros 4, so total length become a 8, so that's why we getting the result for 8 DFT samples. So like this, so first once again see here, first we have taken a input 1100, then we have defined the function, for that function I have written this program, okay, using a total factor logic. So then we have taken a absolute and angle of that. So I hope you like this video. If you like, then please subscribe and comment on my channel and also share this video. Thank you everyone.